Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be creating two more blending vector art design. We'll show you different styles you can achieve using some techniques. We'll also discuss some additional tips during the process. So let's begin with the tutorial. We'll start out with our first design. Create out a small circle using ellipse tool. Now with the Alt press, just click and drag to create a duplicate. Scale up the circle a little bit. Create a duplicate of the edited circle and place it around here. Then scale it up a little bit more. We'll follow the same steps and create our few more circles. We'll do the arrangement in a zigzag pattern, followed by increasing size simultaneously. Set the circles in a proper order to get a nice pattern. Now, next step is to add the blending shapes. In the previous episode, we have applied blending between only two objects. But this time, we'll apply the blendings to multiple objects. So select all the circles using the selection tool. Choose the blend tool from the tool panel and click on any side of the circle. For this design, we'll be clicking on the left side of each circle. If you click the vice versa, you'll get cross section blendings in between. That can be useful to create different patterns. Once the blending is applied to all the circles, select it and double click on the blending tool to open the blending option panel. Here, set the spacing to specified steps and the value around 33 and click OK. Now remove the fill color and change the stroke thickness to 0.25 points. Let's do some adjustments using the direct selection tool. Select the anchor point of the spline to move the individual circles. Next, we'll change few of the sharp corners to rounded, so double click on the design using the selection tool and select the spline. Now using the anchor point tool, click and drag the points to make it curve. Do this for all the anchor points which are on the right side. Add one more circle on the top to finish the design evenly. Select the main design and the circle and apply blending between them using the blend tool. Next, reduce the length of the lower handle of each anchor point using the direct selection tool. This will add more perspective look to the design. Next, give a stroke thickness of 0.1 points and the steps value to 95. Change the stroke color to faded pink. Now drag and drop to new Photoshop document. Rotate your design to 90 degree angle. Double click on the layer to open layer style panel. Apply gradient overlay and choose a preset. Double click on the color slider to change the color. Do the same for the other slider and click OK. Now add hue and saturation adjustment layer. Increase the saturation value to plus 64 and adjust the hue slider to get a gradient of blue and red color. To add a contrast to your design, add brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Set the contrast to 21 and the brightness to minus 36. We'll do some color adjustments under gradient overlay to get a nice contrasting color. Next, duplicate the layer, reduce the opacity and change the layer mode to screen. Give Gaussian blur value around 2. Now add a mask and hide out the front portion using the soft brush tool. Now selecting the main layer, go to filter, blur gallery, tilt shift. Adjust the rotation, spacing and the blur value to give focus to the design. This will create a depth of field. Finally, add a text for the title, type out blending tube vector art with proper font and size. For the second design, we'll create alphabet and numbers using basic shapes. Use rulers to add guidelines. Now create a rectangle with a stroke thickness around 24 points. Use scissor tool to cut out the strokes into two parts. Delete the top piece and reduce the width. Next, select direct selection tool and click and drag the circular icon to make the corners round. Then go to Object, Path, Outline, Stroke. This will convert the stroke to fill object. Scale the size according to the guidelines. Select the top two corner points and make the corners round. Do the same for the other two corners. And we got alphabet J. Next, create alphabet K. Use rectangle tool to create a rectangle. Draw a shape using the pen tool and subtract it from the rectangle. Now, using the direct selection tool, make all the corners round. In the same way, create our 4, A and R. Now select alphabet J and give the stroke thickness of 0.1 points. Create a duplicate with a shortcut Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control F to paste in front. Then with the shift press, scale down the size of the duplicate. Select both the objects and go to Object, Blend, Make to add blends in between. We'll increase the number of steps to around 90 and reduce the stroke thickness to 0.06 points. Apply the same steps for alphabet K, make the corners round to give smooth flow. Do the same for 4, R and A. Once you complete adding all the blends, Let's drag and drop the individual alphabets in the new Photoshop document. Scale up the size using the transform option and place them in a proper order. Maintain equal distance between each alphabets. Adjust the size to give balance to the design. Now add a black background and double click on the alphabet layer to apply gradient overlay. Change the slider color to greenish blue and the other slider color to light blue. Flip the position of the slider to change the direction of the color in the alphabet and click OK. Do this for all the alphabets layer. Next, add human saturation adjustment layer. Increase the saturation value to around +60 and the hue value to around +40. This will add bluish tone to the overall design. Add brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Set the brightness value to around 21 and the contrast value to 23. Finally, we have completed designing blending vector art. There is an announcement for everyone. From now onwards, there will be a regular contest on our channel. For each session that I do, now you can participate in creating your own design using the techniques which you have seen on the episode and send your copies for the same. I'll look into all the submissions and will show the best design in the next video. For this week's contest, create a unique design using the techniques which I have mentioned in the Blending Vector Art episode series. Share your work to our Twitter, Instagram or Facebook with the hashtag #CreatnprocessContest. I hope to see everyone participating. Let's make the learning experience better. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you are not a student in designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.